Good evening, everybody. You're very welcome to our service of Holy Communion on this Maundy Thursday. And it's a delight to welcome parishioners from around the diocese. We've been going through to various different places this week as we've followed in the footsteps of Jesus. About 20 years ago in All Saints here, we introduced a CB radio system for our housebound parishioners. And it was as good as it was in its day. But then about 4 or 5 years ago, the company that put in our CB system said we could put a camera in. And so for the last 4 or 5 years, we've been able to stream our services live every time we're in this beautiful building to worship. And at the beginning of the lockdown, we did an audit of our parishioners, and we found out there were about 24, 25 parishioners who didn't have internet. And so in the lockdown, they really were locked out from worship. And we were able to get about 24 iPad tablet devices. And thanks to Peter's expertise, on a Monday morning, there's a team of people go out and deliver the service in the iPad. It's a three-touch system. I wouldn't be the most technically astute, but three touches, and our parishioners are able to watch the service. And then the tablet's picked up again on Friday. And that is something out of this pandemic that we will continue. If you were watching last night, David Ferguson up in Ballycastle, he's using the same system as ourselves and Philip Benson and Christchurch Cathedral, a number of places, and it's a company called Church Media TV. We're not here to plug them, but if you would like to find out a little bit more, why don't you contact ourselves, or if you're up on the North Coast, David Ferguson would be very pleased to show you around, or Philip Benson, who is in Larne Kilwater and Cairncastle. About £3,000 will do it. And one of the tremendous things about this system, last year we had a funeral, and two nephews of the deceased were able to see their uncle's funeral. One was in New Zealand, and one was in Los Angeles. And on Saturday we had a wedding, and the bride's brother in Australia was able to plug into our service. And I can remember one baptism we had, and Grandest Sam was in Chicago, and we brought his grandson, little baby Sam, down to the back camera, and he was so pleased all that way in Chicago, was able to join us live here in All Saints. So maybe if you have a little bit of money and you're wondering how do we come out of this pandemic, we could really vouch that this is a tremendous way to invest in the future and also to connect with your parishioners who are at home. This evening, just to introduce ourselves, Peter Blake is curate and Claire Thompson is training for OLM. You cannot see Alex, our organist and pianist, and Brian is doing our audiovisuals. And tonight, two of our parishioners, Connor and Victoria, are going to lead our singing. Just earlier in the year, Connor and Victoria, they topped the charts in South Africa with their version of Danny Boy. And they have just recently recorded a song in St. Anne's Cathedral, which they're going to sing for us tonight. But I can assure you that they will really enhance our praise this evening. Throughout the season of Lent, we have this cross, and it's a great Mother's Union idea. And the significant thing about the cross is it's made from a Christmas tree. And the world loves Jesus and Santa and reindeers and all those kind of things. But come the 12th night, most people have a tendency to pack Jesus away with all the decorations. But that's not what we're here for today. And throughout the season of Lent, we have added various elements to the cross. There was a great heresy that Jesus didn't die. And the grave clothes remind us that he died. And on Sunday, we'll think about those grave clothes that were laying in the empty tomb. The only time that Jesus was hailed King of Kings and Lord of Lords was in that time of trial, and they robed him in purple, and they mocked him, and they spat upon him. And then the INRI. This was written above the cross, Jesus of Nazareth, the King of the Jews, in Latin, Aramaic, and Greek, the three main languages of that time. And it reminds us that Jesus didn't die just for the religious people. He died for everyone. In the same as the wise men came and opened salvation to the Gentiles, Jesus died for everyone. The only crown that he ever had was the crown of thorns. On Mothering Sunday, we have this to represent the tears of our mother. Can we begin to imagine what it was like for Mary to see her son, who was only 33, die on the cross. And to have these horrible nails into his hands and his feet. And one of the things that kills you in crucifixion, there was a little seat just at your bottom. And the cross was done in such a way as that the victim had to lift themselves up. And you died on the cross, not from the wounds in your hands and your feet, but from suffocation. And if the body was, the person on the cross was going to be there for too long, the soldier would come along with a big mallet and break the legs so that you couldn't lift yourself up and you would die. The last thing we add to the cross tonight, and I'm not going to steal Peter's thunder, when Jesus met with the disciples in the upper room to celebrate the Passover meal, it was Jesus who took on the role of the lowest slave, put a towel around himself, got a bowl, and he washed 12 pairs of smelly feet. King of kings, Lord of lords, the servant king. And that's who we're here to worship this evening. Jesus was a man who had a hard time with the religious people of the day. And yet he gave us two things to do. He said, go and baptize, make disciples of all nations, baptizing in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. He told us to baptize. And then on this night, the night of the Passover meal, he said, do this in remembrance of me every time you break the bread and bless the cup. Those are the two things. And they are two of the fundamental channels of grace that he provides us with. And so we begin our worship with our hymn 642, Amazing Grace, How Sweet the Sound. Our service can be found on page 201 of our prayer books. It's Holy Communion 2, page 201. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Almighty God. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord. Amen. Hear what our Lord Jesus Christ says. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind. This is the first and great commandment, and the second is like it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. On these two commandments depend all the law and the prophets. Lord, have mercy on us and write these your laws in our hearts. God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, Jesus Christ, to save us from our sins, to intercede for us in heaven, and to bring us to eternal life. Let us then confess our sins in penitence and faith, firmly resolved to keep God's commandments and to live in love and peace. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned in thought and word and deed, and in what we have left undone. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may walk in newness of life to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy on you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness and keep you in eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The Collect of Maundy Thursday. O Lord, who in a wonderful sacrament has left us a memorial of thy passion, grant us so to reverence the sacred mysteries of thy body and blood, that we may perceive within ourselves the fruits of thy redemption, who livest and reignest with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Amen. Almighty and everlasting God, you hate nothing that you have made, and forgive the sins of all those who are penitent. Create and make in us new and contrite hearts, that we, worthily lamenting our sins and acknowledging our wretchedness, may receive from you, the God of all mercy, perfect remission and forgiveness, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
A reading from the first epistle of St. Paul to the Corinthians, chapter 11, beginning at verse 23. For I received from the Lord what I also passed on to you. The Lord Jesus, on the night he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, broke it and said, "This is my body, which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, after supper he took the cup, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this, whenever you drink it, in remembrance of me. For whenever you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our next hymn is 224, How Deep the Father's Love for Us. Hymn 224.
The Father's love for us. sons to glory.
Hear the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to St. John, chapter 13, beginning at verse 1.
Glory to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
It was just before the Passover festival. Jesus knew that the hour had come for him to leave this world and go to the Father. Having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. The evening meal was in progress, and the devil had already prompted Judas, the son of Simon Iscariot, to betray Jesus. Jesus knew that the Father had put all things under his power, and that he had come from God and was returning to God. So he got up from the meal, took off his outer clothing, and wrapped a towel around his waist. After that, he poured water into a basin and began to wash his disciples' feet, drying them with the towel that was wrapped around him. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Lord, are you going to wash my feet?" Jesus replied, "You do not realize now what I am doing, but later you will understand." "No," said Peter, "you shall never wash my feet." Jesus answered, "Unless I wash you, you have no part with me." "Then, Lord," Simon Peter replied, "not just my feet, but my hands and my head as well." Jesus answered, "Those who have had a bath need only to wash their feet. Their whole body is clean. And you are clean, though not every one of you." For he knew who was going to betray him, and that was why he said not everyone was clean. When he had finished washing their feet, he put on his clothes and returned to his place. "Do you understand what I have done for you?" he asked them. "You call me teacher and Lord, and rightly so, for that is what I am. Now that I, your Lord and teacher, have washed your feet, you also should wash one another's feet. I have set you an example that you should do as I have done for you. Very truly I tell you, no servant is greater than his master, nor is a messenger greater than the one who sent him. Now that you know these things, you will be blessed if you do them." Jesus said, "Now the Son of Man is glorified, and God is glorified in him. If God is glorified in him, God will glorify the Son in himself, and will glorify him at once. My children, I will be with you only a little longer. You will look for me, And just as I told the Jews, so I tell you now, where I am going, you cannot come. A new command I give you, love one another. As I have loved you, so you must love one another. By this everyone will know that you are my disciples, if you love one another. This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
And may I speak in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. What a privilege to read that on Monday, Thursday. What a reading. You know, John's account of Jesus washing the feet of the disciples must surely seem especially relevant to us this year. I took my daughter to a routine appointment in Musgrave Park Hospital the other day. Anybody who's been visiting the hospital recently will know this, that there are sanitizers everywhere, absolutely everywhere. You're tripping over them, you're knocking them over every time you turn around. There's sanitizers everywhere, on the tables, at the waiting area, constant reminders of the need for cleanliness, the need to keep others safe and to protect the people we love. And rightly so, because otherwise we wouldn't be able to do simple things like attend a hospital appointment or even enjoy the daily excitement of a walk, probably the same walk, or a nosy around our favorite supermarket looking for a wee bargain or more snacks. Because we've got quite through quite a few of those recently, haven't we? In our reading from John 13, by washing their feet, Jesus was teaching his disciples, the same ones who argued about who was going to be the greatest in the kingdom, that to follow him was to put aside pride, put aside self-service, and to foster a servant heart, to learn to love as he loved. The way of humility, the way of the kingdom, where those who humble themselves are exalted, and those who are very proud are put to shame. A world where those who call themselves Christians care for each other and wash feet that have been muddied or scarred or injured on life's journeys in other people. You might be surprised to hear me say that I think the ash or the act of washing our hands with sanitizer is in some ways very similar to the washing of feet that Jesus demonstrates. When we take the time to wash our hands with sanitizer and put on a mask, we are showing people that we care enough about them to be careful and considerate. We give those few seconds of our time rubbing that awful gunk onto our hands once more to protect others and to let those who feel vulnerable and fearful feel safe to stand beside us. Washing our own hands in these days is indeed a small way of serving the needs of others. The problem is that whether we are washing feet in first century Jerusalem or washing hands in 21st century Northern Ireland, this cleaning always needs to be repeated. Teeth need brushed twice a day if you want to get a good kiss. Clothes need spun and hands need dried. Hands must be rubbed with that awful gunk all day long. And cleaning seems to be an endless Herculean task. Ask any teenager pointed in the direction of their bedroom. My mother, who's watching tonight, would say, Peter, yours was the worst. Hello, Mum. Easter is a great time of year for getting rid of clutter and clearing and cutting back in the garden, for emptying cupboards of unused wrapping paper and clothes that no longer fit after a year of watching Line of Duty and The Crown with a cup of tea and a plate of biscuits. But then, there are the marks that we cannot remove. And no matter how hard we try and how hard we scrub, there they remain. Some messes that we cannot tidy up by ourselves, because they are on the inside, beyond our reach. The things that only we know and we think about late at night and we have to live with. The hurts that stain how we see the whole world. The anger that makes us see the world through a red veil. the mistakes that we find impossible to remove from the fabric of our lives. These are the parts of our hearts that only our Lord, the Lord Jesus Christ, can reach and carefully and gently with soft hands carefully cleanse and renew. During the Last Supper, when Jesus became fully aware of what was to come, he decides to wash the feet of his friends. By following through with what was ahead of him, enduring the passion and the cross, he washes all of us, outside and inside. And what can we do in return? As much as we may want to over the coming days, we cannot walk alongside him and clean those feet torn by the rough stones under the weight of the cross, or tend to his wounds caused by the beatings and the whip, or bathe his feet battered and bruised and nailed to the cross. But we can clean the feet of those that he died for and trusts us to care for. We can bathe and comfort the tired feet of anyone who would have our help or our prayers. For it is in serving like Jesus, sharing his love and his message with those in our towns and our cities and our parishes, that we do follow his example and wash the feet of those around us.
Good evening, everyone. It's really lovely to be here tonight and to sing for you all. So Connor and I tonight are going to sing a song which we think is really appropriate for this difficult time. So it's originally sung by Andrea Bocelli and Catherine Jenkins, and it's a song which is all about hope and how if we all spread love and love one another, it would make such a big difference in the world. So we hope you enjoy this. It's called I Believe.
I believe.
We affirm our faith as we say together the Nicene Creed. We believe. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate by the Holy Spirit of the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us pray.
O Lord our God, tonight we meet to remember our Saviour Jesus Christ and his sacrifice of love for us. We remember his last meal with his closest friends and disciples. We recall the command given to them to love one another. We pause to remember the betrayal Jesus would suffer and the pain that would be his to bear. Let us pray for the whole Church of God that it may grow in unity and servanthood. Help us to know that we are connected by the one who created us all. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
We remember our leaders of the church, especially our bishop, Archbishop John and Bishop George. We also pray for our congregation of All Saints and for all the congregations of the Diocese of Connor, that in these holy days we may grow in love for one another and all people. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For all the leaders of the world and all the people who live in it, we pray that reconciliation and peace may overcome conflict and oppression. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
For the hungry, in body or spirit, for the sick and those in pain, for the lonely and the forgotten, for the dying and for all who mourn, we pray that they may feel the full extent of God's love for them. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Merciful Father, accept these our prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
Amen. We do not presume. We do not presume to come to this your table, merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in your manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under your table. But you are the same, Lord, whose nature is always to have mercy. Grant us therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of your dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our sinful bodies may be made clean by his body, and our souls washed through his most precious blood, and that we may evermore dwell in him, and he in us. Amen. Now, in union with Christ Jesus, you who were once far off have been brought near through the shedding of Christ's blood, for he is our peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
And we can metaphorically dunt elbows and shake peace. Peace be with you all. going to sing our hymn, which is number 2 in our hymn book, and we're going to sing it twice, and it's Faithful One, hymn number 2. Be present be present, Lord Jesus Christ, our risen high priest. Make yourself known in the breaking of bread.
Amen. Amen.
Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed for us. Therefore, let us celebrate the feast. The Lord is here.
His Spirit is with us.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
Father, almighty and ever-living God, at all times and in all places, it is right to give you thanks and praise. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior, who, for the redemption of the world, humbled himself to death of the cross, that being lifted up from the earth, he might draw all people to himself. And so, with all your people, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and saying, Holy, 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 God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed are you, Father, the creator and sustainer of all things. You made us in your own image, male and female, you created us. Even when we turned away from you, you never ceased to care for us. But in your love and mercy, you freed us from the slavery of sin, giving your only begotten Son to become man and suffer death on the cross to redeem us. He made there the one complete and all-sufficient sacrifice for the sins of the whole world. He instituted, and in his holy gospel commanded us to continue a perpetual memory of his precious death until he comes again. On the night that he was betrayed, he took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup. And when he had given thanks to you, he gave it to them, saying, Drink this, all of you. For this is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. Therefore, Father, with this bread and this cup, we do as Christ your Son commanded. We remember his passion and death. We celebrate his resurrection and ascension. And we look for the coming of his kingdom. Accept through him, our great high priest, this our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. And as we eat and drink these holy gifts, grant by the power of the life-giving Spirit that we may be made one in your holy church and partakers of the body and blood of your Son, that he may dwell in us and we in him. Through the same Jesus Christ, our Lord, by whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory are yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Amen. As our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The bread which we break is a sharing in the body of Christ. We, being many, are one body, for we all share in the one bread. Draw near with faith. Receive the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which he gave for you, and his blood, which he shed for you. Remember that he died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. Christ, keep you in eternal life.
Amen.
The body of Christ, keep you in eternal life. The body of Christ, keep you in eternal life. The body of Christ, keep you in eternal life. The body of Christ, keep you in eternal life. Body of Christ to keep you in eternal life. Lord Jesus Christ, in this wonderful sacrament you have given us a memorial of your passion. Grant us so to reverence the sacred mysteries of your body and blood, that we may know within ourselves the fruits of your redemption. For you are alive and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the spiritual food of the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen. Just before we conclude our worship this evening, today, as we've said, is Maundy Thursday, and on Maundy Thursday, the Queen gives out Maundy money, and we can bask in the glory of one of our parishioners, Mrs. Paddy Wallace, who today received the Maundy purse. And if you want to find out about Paddy, read on the diocesan website. Paddy was our branch chairperson of the Mothers Union. Then she was diocesan president and All-Ireland president. So Paddy's known the length and breadth of Northern Ireland and Ireland for her work in the Mothers Union and well beyond these shores. But also Paddy was vice principal of Park Hall School, and as the management team there in the 80s and 90s helped just to raise Park Hall into the premier school that it is today. So Paddy has given our parish and our town and beyond so much of her service. And in the citation, she has had very much a servant ministry here in All Saints, but I think most of all a ministry of support and encouragement. So, Paddy, our congratulations to you and to John. It's just a pity you can't get over to London to see the Queen. But many, many congratulations and well deserved. And then also to Bello Jewell, thank you for your singing this evening. And you'll find, if you just Google Bello Jewell, I said about not giving plugs. Well, a plug for Bello Jewell and your I Believe is online, which was recorded in St. Anne's Cathedral. So all the very best to you. I hope we will see that you are the new Andrea Bocelli and Catherine Jenkins, but you're the Bello Jewell. So thank you for all of that. So tonight, as we have remembered the first celebration of the Holy Communion, we now turn and hopefully have the courage to walk with Christ as he faces the cross. And we're going to sing our final hymn, which is number 70 from Thanks and Praise. And it is Jesus Christ, I Think Upon Your Sacrifice. Hymn number 70 from Thanks and Praise. Thank you.
wondered at your gift of life, and I'm in that place once again. And I'm in that place once again. And once again I look upon the cross where you died. I'm humbled by your mercy, and I'm broken inside. Once again I thank you, once again I pour out my life. Now you are exalted to the highest place, King of the heavens, for one day I'll bow. But for now, I marvel at this saving grace, and I'm full of praise once again. I'm full of praise once again. And once again I look upon the cross where you died. I'm humbled by your mercy, and I'm broken inside. Once again I thank you, once again I pour out my life. Thank you for the cross, thank you for the cross, thank you for the cross, my friend. Thank you for the cross, thank you for the cross, thank you for the cross, my friend. And once again I look upon the cross where you died. I'm humbled by your mercy, and I'm broken inside. Once again I thank you, once again I pour out my life.
And our concluding blessing. Christ draw you to himself, and grant that you find in his cross a sure ground for faith, a firm support for hope, and the assurance of sins forgiven. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you always.
Amen.
God bless you.